Luckily, I
babies, bro.
Oh, hey, didn't see you guys there. Oh, it's that one. Okay. Well, I'm Carter Peters. I'd like to welcome everyone who's tuning in and everyone who's here live. It's really awesome that you're here. Now that's working. That's cool. We're all really glad to join us during these difficult times. Having to transition to an online learning environment at this point in our high school careers wasn't something that any of us saw coming. Needless to say, it's been difficult. Not only did we have to keep up on our academic studies, but we also had to prepare for our rapidly approaching futures. Despite these obstacles, we still made it. Through everything that's happened, we still find ourselves on the big stage, standing up here as you guys all take your pictures, stare at us, and overall just try your best. Try to embarrass us to the best of your abilities. But if you ask me, that's more than enough payment for your unconditional love and support. Once again, I'd like to thank everyone who's here. It's because of you that we find ourselves where we are today. So thank you. I would now like to hand things off to my second in command, Clint Boucher.
You know, we had Carter do our announcements every morning, and it was a sheer pleasure to have him do that. And when we heard that he was going to be introducing this, we were all super, super excited because we knew he was going to do something just like that. Thanks, Carter. That was awesome. So welcome, parents, grandparents, family, friends, board members, and staff. I'd like to personally thank everyone for the impact you have had on shaping these outstanding young ladies and gentlemen. They are the embodiment of all the hard work you put in to raise these wonderful kids. This statement really rings true more this year than ever. Thank you for all your extra attention and the push that some of them needed in order to be sitting here where they are right now. My favorite example of this, and some of them might be scared by me starting by saying this, my favorite example of this is when I called a parent about a child over the shutdown. The student was having a little trouble responding to staff requests, emails, phone calls, that kind of stuff. So I called the parent. And I was talking to them and just kind of explaining things. And they said, well, hold on, Mr. Boucher. Let me go make sure we all hear the same conversation. So the parent marched up the stairs, and I heard bunk, bunk, bunk upstairs, and they woke the student up. And the student was quite surprised at this. So not only was someone in their room waking them up, but here I was on the phone with them as well. So really could not have done it without you. Class of 2020, it's pretty awesome having you back and having this ceremony. I love seeing your smiley faces, and we are so glad that we can make this happen for you and your families. Students, and I mean this when I say this, you have experienced, I believe, more adversity than any other group of students in my 25 years in education. What you guys went through this year, amazing. And you learned a lot about yourselves, I hope. Now use that strength that got you sitting where you are right now and apply that to your life and to your dreams. Anatole France said, "To accomplish great things, we must not only act, but we must dream. Not only plan, but also believe. Your future is only as good as the work you put into it. You are going to have to work harder than you ever have. But when you get there, you'll be sitting in a place just like you are now. It's not a matter of when you face adversity in your life, but when. Try not to look at all the negatives of this situation, but what you have learned about yourself from this time. What was your personal motivation level during this time? How will this impact your future plans? Did what you did work for you? Or did you grow and learn something about yourself from it?" And I'm sure many of you have. "Life will throw you curveballs. What's important is how you adapt and grow from each experience. We all wanted you to have the experiences and all the things that you missed. But as in life, focus on controlling the things you can control and not on what you cannot control. Focus on the positives from the past and all the wonderful memories you have made. Do not let the one moment define all the great things you have experienced or done. I have a visual for you. I know it's kind of cheesy, but bear with me, all right? So it's low budget, too. Here we are. This water bottle. You see it? Is it full? Close. Very good. Thank you. See that? It's close, right? Well, that can represent all the positive memories you have had here from 4K through 12. I want you to think about the friendships, the relationships, the sports teams, the performances and concerts, plays, competitions, homecomings, proms, dances, and finally your growth as a young person to an adult. Hey, you had the longest senior skip day in recorded history. And after this ceremony, you're going to have a police escort through town. I've never had a police escort through town. Not that I want to discuss or admit to anyone at this moment, but, you know, hey. You know what? I'm sorry. I apologize. I apologize to y'all. I forgot. It's someone's birthday today. We have someone turning 18 years old today. Happy birthday, Jared. Oh, wait. One more. We have someone having a birthday tomorrow. Maybe we all should sing. No, I'm just kidding. We won't do that, but happy birthday tomorrow, Aurora. I look at all your faces and have many fond memories of watching you grow into the young fine ladies and gentlemen that are sitting here today. Now go attack your future with everything you have and reach all of your dreams and goals. Be the hardest working person you can be, because if you're not, someone else will be. Don't let anything stop you. You made it this far, now keep going. Congratulations, class of 2020. I could not be more proud of each and every one of you. I'd like to introduce Miss Heather Kramer.
Good evening, and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the Hustisford High School Class of 2020. Welcome to parents, grandparents, other relatives and friends, staff and school board members of the Hustisford School District, and most of all, welcome back to the graduates. Little did you all know that on March 17th, when you walked out of the doors of this building, you would not return for the remainder of your senior year. Little did you know that education as you knew it was going to change. At that point in your life, there were so many unknowns. I recall talking to you all in the cafeteria prior to closing our school buildings, and little did I know that that would be the last time that we would address you all as a class in person until this evening. Things have really changed. Your home became your classroom. For some of you, your school day started earlier and ended similar to what it had been before. For some of you, your school day started at maybe 2 o'clock when you decided to roll out of bed. Y'all had to make adjustments and changes to meet the challenges that you faced. You had two choices. You could face those challenges with determination and grit, or you could just ignore them. This is exactly how it will be in your life. Franklin Roosevelt stated, "If we attack our problems with determination, we shall succeed." You will be faced with many adversities and challenging. The deciding factor in your success is how you handle them and how you decide to move forward. Be strong, be courageous, work hard, and do not let adversity slow you down. Winston Churchill described success as the ability to go from one failure to another with no loss of enthusiasm. Class of 2020, consider your story that you will be able to tell. The story of the class of 2020 will certainly be historical. You have faced different challenges, you have achieved milestones differently, and you have adjusted to new ways of learning. Much of your story, however, is yet to be told. You will start, or have already started, writing that next chapter in your story. Some of you started your educational journey here at JHE, and others joined us later on. The time that you joined your class, it doesn't really matter. What matters is that you joined and that you are a Falcon. You more than likely started kindergarten, excited about getting new school supplies and new clothes to wear to school and riding that big yellow bus. You met new friends, you learned many things, and you established yourself first as a Hustisford student. By the end of fourth grade, you know so much. You had mastered multiplication, you could write in cursive, you could play the recorder. Summer was a time to hang out with friends, and sometimes they seemed to drag on way too long, and you were eager to get back to school in the fall. You probably started to really get a grasp on what you want to be when you grow up. The next big step was middle school. Remember those days? You were officially a little fish in a big pond. You looked so little compared to the others in the building. You were not sure how you would ever be able to open a locker and get to the next class and probably stop in the bathroom in 3 minutes. Life was truly stressful. I would venture to guess that you all thought you were pretty cool at this time as well. Friends became really, really important to you through middle school, and your parents didn't really probably know too much according to you. Middle school is a crazy time that you can all look back upon and smile and laugh about. Finally, you were freshmen. It was an exciting time. Although you were in the same building, there were new adventures to begin in high school. Starting high school can be intimidating, but one common thread was there with you the entire time, your friendships. You have been through a lot together. You have had happy times, you have had challenging times. Tonight, you gather here in this place that you have called home for the past 13 years. This place that you have come to know inside and out. This place holds many, many memories that you are going to cherish for a long time. This place has shaped who you are. It has shaped your story. The story involves all of the individuals up here with you tonight. It involves your parents, your other family members, and your teachers. The staff here at Hustisford truly cares about each and every one of you. They're grateful that they have been able to be part of your story. Staff, I truly appreciate all that you do each day, engaging and challenging our students and leading them towards success. Students, as you sit here tonight gathered in this place, probably for the last time ever as an entire class, you're finishing a chapter in your story and you're beginning the next. Class of 2020, your story is not ending. You should be proud that you come from a community and a school that cares so deeply about you. This is your place. In the words of Tim McGraw, chase your dreams, but always know the road that's going to lead you home again. Embrace the adventures that will all begin, but know that we are here. We will continue to be a part of your story forever. we will always have a place here for you. You all have so much to be proud of, and we wish you the best of luck in all of your future endeavors. Henry David Thoreau said it best, "Go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life that you have imagined." Congratulations, class of 2020. I am proud of all that you have accomplished. Be strong and be courageous. You make us all Hustie proud. I have the pleasure this evening to introduce our guest speaker chosen by the class of 2020. It is with great pleasure and pride that I introduce to you Mrs. Dawn Wolling.
This one? Yep. I'm too short. Oh. Close. I have a loud voice, so. Hello, everyone. Mrs. Wolling here. You know, I struggled with how I wanted to start my speech this evening, as there were so many unknowns. Would we be live or virtual? Would you all be sitting in front of me, or would you be watching this at some point with your friends and family? And on and on and on. I decided to start my speech the way I started every video that I made for my students during this unprecedented situation of online learning and homeschooling, a time when things were so different and things so unsure, when I was unable to see my students face to face each and every day, the preferred way of teaching, trying to make the connection that was somehow lost in the internet and be myself, who I am, Mrs. Wolling. So hello, everyone. Mrs. Wolling here. I am so very pleased and blessed to have been given the opportunity to be your speaker this evening, so thank you. I'm going to be honest, when Ms. Spanish sent me the email that asked if I would like to be your commencement speaker, my first thought, as my heart jumped from my chest into my mouth, was, I can't do that. It would be too scary. I really don't think I could do it. But as I thought a bit more, I thought of my students. The ones I stand in front of every day and remembered all of the times I said these words to them. Use your voice. You must speak up for yourself. You must be heard. And so I said yes. That being said, tonight I get to stand here before you and share my passion and use my voice. I have had the privilege to have taught many of you from the moment you were little, from that very moment that you started school, and some of you just a little while. Let you go and then had the moment to get to know you once again through other avenues throughout the course of the years. It has been an honor and a blessing to be your teacher. And tonight, I get to use my voice and passion to speak about the most important thing we celebrate here, you. The people you are and the people you will become. The place where you started and the place where you are going. Honestly, I can't imagine how I could have thought about turning this opportunity down. What a blessing it is to send you off on your way to go out into the world and do great things. For that is what you are going to do. You are going out into the world to make a difference, be the change, and be the light. Tonight for my speech, I have chosen to use something that I have used often at the elementary school. At John Hustis, we practice something called the bees. No, not the fuzzy things that fly around and land on flowers. The B's are the expectations that we have for our students at the elementary school, the way we expect that they will conduct themselves and interact with one another. The B's, I believe, are pretty straightforward. They are be respectful, be responsible, and be ready to learn. Straightforward, maybe, but not necessarily always easy to accomplish. However, most definitely something to work towards and to strive for. So as I was thinking about what I wanted to say to you tonight in this speech, I reflected on those simple yet lofty ideals and decided that I would like to speak to you about the B's that I feel just might be important to you as you move forward on your journey through life, into the unknown and out into the world. Three B's to send you on your way with some thoughts to reflect upon and some lofty goals to set for yourself. For having a goal, even if it's lofty, is most important. The three B's of life, if you will, and they are, be persistent, be the change, and be the light. These three things I feel will serve you well as you go out onto your own to make your way in this world and hopefully make it a better place. For that is my wish for you and for me and for all of the adults in this room. For you are the hope of our future. So let's get started with the three B's of making the world a better place. Let's start with be persistent. Be persistent. What exactly does that mean? James Whitcomb Riley said the most essential factor is persistence, the determination never to allow your energy or enthusiasm to be dampened by the discouragement that must inevitably come. I believe by now you must realize that life is hard. It isn't fair. Just look at all you've been through in these past 5 months. You missed out on a large part of your last year of high school due to COVID-19. You missed out on your final season of sports, prom, hanging out with your friends, all of your many lasts that you look forward to as a senior in high school, and yet you persisted. You completed that fourth quarter. You finished your senior projects. You did what you needed to do because it had to be done. Kudos to you for doing that. And it is my belief because of that you will emerge stronger and more ready than any group of seniors before you to take on the challenges that you will face outside these walls. You will need to be persistent to face the things that are yet to come. College is hard. Working is hard. Adulting is hard. Take it from one who knows and then ask all these people sitting out there. However, if you are persistent, if you refuse to let your energy and enthusiasm be dampened by discouragement, you will be successful. Disappointment is inevitable, but it is how you handle it that makes all the difference. I know that you will remain persistent and strong in anything that comes your way because of the challenges you have faced and taken on already. You will emerge victorious in anything life throws your way. This then leads us to the next B, be the change. It has long since been my motto, be the change you wish to see in the world, a quote from Mahatma Gandhi. When I started teaching because I loved music and I wanted to share that love with my students. I wanted to share with them the joy that making music can bring, and truthfully, it still is. However, as I continued in my years of teaching, I realized that there was so much more that I wanted to do beyond sharing my love of music with my students. I wanted to make a difference in the world, one student at a time, and I hoped that through my hard work, it would inspire my students to do the same. It is said of your generation, Generation Z, that you have a great desire to change the world and make it a better place. How many examples of that have we seen lately in the news? Students rising up to the challenge and challenging ideas that they feel strongly about, change they want to have happen, being the change they wish to see in the world. However, in our little town of Hustisford, in our school, we see students rising up and trying to change the world each and every day as well. I have watched as you have reached out and mentored our youngest students at John Hustis with love and care and kindness, showing them what it means to be a good person, laughing with them, working with them, and just hanging out with them, being the role models you need to be so that those students are able to grow up and be a good person too. I have seen the many different efforts made to make the community a better place through food drives, clothing drives, and even taking time to make cards for someone who was dying from cancer because all he wanted was a little bit of Christmas. Your senior projects, I know for some it seemed overwhelming, but from my experience, having worked with someone one-on-one in my classroom, I saw what a huge impact her efforts had on my students. She was the difference maker in that classroom when I was unsure of how it might go because we were changing things up. You have been and can be the change this world needs. I have seen it already, and I cannot wait to see what you do with the future. This leads us to our last B, be the light. One of my most favorite songs is This Little Light of Mine. I love it because of the message it spreads. What it says to us as the listener. Although I love the first verse, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. I love the second verse even more. Hide it under a bushel? No, I'm gonna let it shine. That, my friends, is what I wish for you. I want you to go out into this world and let your light shine. Shine bright in all you do, as sometimes it may be difficult, but it is oh so very important. Marianne Williamson said, as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people the permission to do the same. We may be afraid to let our light shine, afraid to let it shine for seeming that we are full of ourselves, that others will think that we are bragging, or it might just mean we're putting ourselves out there. That is when it is even more important to let your light shine. I have seen firsthand in my music classroom students who themselves may be struggling, and yet when faced with someone who needs that light, they have risen to the occasion with hugs, tears, love, and understanding, letting each of us see their vulnerability, their light being shared with one another. Each and every one of you sitting here tonight has so much potential, so much to offer, and so much to give the world. Do not let the world make you feel small and insignificant. Do not hide your light under a bushel. Get out there and shine bright, brighter than the stars. Blaze a path and make the journey your own. Let your light shine. As I finish my speech here this evening, I will state yet again that although this unprecedented situation has made our life different, forced us to live a new normal, I believe in the end we will all emerge the better for it. One of the best things to come out of this ordeal for me has been the ability to make so many connections with other teachers from all over the United States and all over the world. Being able to see this from a different perspective has been a blessing for me. One of those teachers who I have discovered is a man named Tony G. Tonight, I want to leave you with one of his writings that he shared on social media, as I feel it is so incredibly fitting for this evening. It is a writing about a conversation between himself and life. Me. There is so much anger. Life, your gentleness is needed. Me, a single word cannot calm the world. Life, it doesn't need to. It needs simply be heard by another. Me, there is so much darkness. Life, your candle is needed. Me, a single candle cannot light the world. Life, it doesn't need to. It needs simply light another's candle. Me, there is so much brokenness. Life, your healing is needed. Me, a single touch cannot heal the world. Life, it doesn't need to, it needs simply be felt by another. Me, there is so much hatred. Life, your love is needed. Me, a simple act of love cannot change the world. Life, it doesn't need to, it needs simply change another's heart. Me, are you saying I can make a difference? Life, you need to. I leave you tonight with those words. Can you make a difference? Yes. Not only can you make a difference, you need to make a difference. Thanks for listening tonight. I wish you many blessings in your future of class of 2020. Thank you for all the blessings you have already given me. Good night. And our next speaker will be Miss Megan Blumhoff.
Mr. Boucher stole like half my speech and one of my jokes, so thanks for that one. Yeah. Okay. 7 very, very long years ago, the class of 2020 held our 5th grade graduation ceremony in the elementary school gymnasium. 2 students were chosen to give a speech, and I just happened to be one of them. Being the very much not public speaker that I was, and frankly still am, I struggled with thinking of what to say. My older brother, who had just graduated high school the year before, only gave me some very unhelpful advice. Nobody remembers 5th grade graduation. It's the high school graduation speeches that matter. I somehow managed to make it through the dreaded speech, and apparently my brother was right, because I don't remember a single word I said. But I proceeded to spend the next 7 years telling myself, okay, never doing that again. Skip to a sudden change in plans when I was told I was a salutatorian, and I would, in fact, be doing that again. 2020, if anything else, has been a year of literally nothing going as planned. Our class was supposed to continue our final semester as high school students as normal seniors do. Spring athletes were supposed to have their final season. Band and choir students were supposed to have their last spring concert. We were supposed to have a senior class trip, and our school was supposed to be pranked. Instead, we're in the middle of a global pandemic, and all of these events and milestones we've been looking forward to for years have been canceled, rescheduled, and modified to fit current safety standards. We haven't been in a physical classroom since March, we're graduating in July instead of in May, and rather than senior skip day, we had senior skip quarter. It really is unfortunate that the class of 2020 has missed so many once-in-a-lifetime opportunities. However, our lives do not begin and end with senior year. We still have our entire lives ahead of us, and luckily, most people do not peak in high school, so it's bound to only go up from here. Plus, if the past year of our lives have taught us anything, because I'm sure half of us didn't retain a word from virtual learning, it's how to roll with the punches. When rules are changed almost every single day, new scientific evidence is found on the regular, and every other store or business has a different view on the state of the world and has a different way of handling it, you learn to adapt very quickly. While it's sad that this is the reason we had to become so good at accepting change and dealing with unforeseen circumstances, it is an important life skill to have, and the fact that this class has that ability makes the future look promising. Our senior year of high school was filled with laughs, but there are still more to come. This will not be the final time something doesn't go the way we want it to. This is not the last time we'll make plans, and they'll change drastically. Hopefully, this is the last time I'll be making a speech at graduation. 2020 has proven time and time again that you can never fully expect what's happening next, but you can and will make it through whatever life throws at you, like a pandemic or an asteroid, or if you're really unlucky, giant bees. That being said, we're not the only ones who have nearly perfected the art of simply making things work. Thank you to the staff at Hustisford High School for doing the best you can to help students learn from their homes. Thank you to everybody who came as a guest today, because I know not everybody is comfortable in crowds these days. And especially thank you to the class of 2020 for finally being able to agree on something, for the most part, with minimal fighting in our group chat. It's cheesy to say we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you, but we probably literally would not be here. And now for our valedictorian, Ryan Kanoki.
Pretty good, or like closer, like that. Okay, good. All right. Well, I'd just like to say you all did great for those who spoke before me. And I would like to start off by saying thank you to each and every one of you for being here on this very important day. Not only are we here to celebrate one of the greatest achievements at this point in our lives, but we're also showing our appreciation for one another as we look at the long journey we have taken to get to this destination. We have all left a mark on each other's lives, whether it be for better or for worse, it doesn't matter. All that matters is that the history we've created here has shaped us into the distinct individuals we are today, and that we should never hope to change. Our individuality is the only thing in this life that distinguishes us from one another, that makes us unique, that gives us an intangible value to each one of our lives. Each and every one of us is special in our own way, and we must never forget that. So again, thank you all for being here. It's sad that we're in a time where large gatherings with our loved ones are prohibited, thus only allowing for there to be a small number with us today, but these times are unparalleled. We are the graduates of 2020 after all, and we're only in July. Who knows what the rest of the year has in store for us. Hopefully this is a year to go down the books as the year of the corona, and not just the start of a future that we're haunted by the damages viruses cause. This is a year when the entire world has faced an issue and decided to come together and try to solve it. We may not be the doctors working in labs trying to create a vaccine, but we are still playing an essential role that has the power to make a difference. These adjustments aren't easy, but we're getting through it together. I am hopeful with society's determination, we will find a solution to the current problems plaguing our planet. Okay. Regardless of what our future holds, one thing remains true every day. We're all given the opportunity, the privilege, to make a choice, one that can change the rest of our lives forever. There are three options we are given when facing a situation, and we all have the choice to make the right one. First option is this. We can choose to make excuses. Oh, I'll start that tomorrow. Or I've been having a long week. I'll work on it next week. Or I can't right now. I'm too tired. Regardless of what the excuse is, we've all made them before and heard them countless times. This is the option to regress, to not only not do anything, but to get worse in at least one aspect of our lives. This is what it means to give up. This is what it means to lose. An excuse only shows that you're afraid of the unknown. And it is perfectly normal to be scared, because every choice you make isn't always going to be the right one, and that can be frightening. But these mistakes help us grow. So you won't grow until you learn to address the problem ahead of you. The second option is to just not change anything, to just keep on keeping on, or don't fix it if it ain't broke. This is the choice of just being comfortable with where you are right now in life and deciding it's not worth the risk to take a chance for a better situation. This is what it means to settle, to not try and strive for a better life, but instead you'd rather give up your power to decide for yourself and let the world make the choices for you. But you don't want to be better. Sometimes things won't always work out, but it's better to have given it your best shot than to have not even tried at all. As I make my way to this last option, I'm sure you get an idea of where I'm going with this. Our final option is the choice to change, to be uncomfortable, to expose yourself to something new, and to learn and adapt to overcome the present situation. To force yourself to learn something new and grow from something in your life that can actually change. It might take some effort, some time, or even a little bit of risk, but that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you fail or succeed. Not all that matters is that you did something. You gave effort, you tried. We're capable of so much more than what we're led to believe. Don't follow anyone unless it gets you closer to your own goals. You'll never truly succeed unless you succeed from within yourself. You'll never succeed through the lens of someone else's eyes, only your own. The great thing about being here at this focal point in our life is that we have another opportunity to make a choice, to look at these three options and to find it within ourselves to want something more out of life. Take a look around us and ask ourselves if we truly are happy, because that is the point of all this, isn't it? To someday experience true happiness. It doesn't matter what that looks like at the end of the tunnel. All that matters is that we're willing to do what it takes to get there, and that we realize that happiness isn't tangible. It is something that we can't explain or put a value on. It is something we are striving someday to truly achieve as we take in a deep breath, look out over the world, and say to ourselves that I won. If you're sitting here today unhappy with the road that you've planned out ahead of you, just know it's not too late. And if you're sitting here unsure of how to change, don't feel guilty. Life is about the experience and keeping an open mind. As long as you try every day to be better, that is all that matters. I know myself that I'm nowhere close to this experience, but this is what I can say. Don't make an excuse. Don't be comfortable. Go after your goals with all you have, no matter how big or how small. Each and every one of us here have the ability to do this, and we'd be doing the world a disservice if we weren't to at least test our potential and go after our goals. Thank you. God, that is so bad. Oh my God.
We wanted the seniors to be able to see the slides, so that's why they're standing back there.
Just so you're wondering.
School board members, the students seated before you tonight have met all requirements of the state of Wisconsin and the Hustisford School District to to earn a Hustisford High School diploma. It is my pleasure to present the graduating class of 2020.
Cheyenne Jade Asen. Allie Mae Berber. Megan June Blumhoff. Brianna Lynn Beck. Madison Ann Brueger. Angelique Belisa Carbon. Caitlin Marie Conley. Devin Anthony Davis. Zachary Walter Davis. Jessica Ann Garsomke. Bradley Stewart Goodland. Jared Allen Herbert Gramlow. Zachary James Kale. Ryan Lewis Kenoki. Both. Julia Ann Leinman. India Marie Luckett. I was about to say the same thing. Nice job. Milana Louise Malter. Grayson James Miller. Ryan Edward Milliken. We told them to face their parents with their diploma. We did. Blake Christopher Olson. Alicia Marie Peplinski. Samantha Lynn Peplinski. I guess the first in command, Carter Andrew Peters. It's there, man. It's there. Ella Marilyn Schmidt. Cody Brian Schmidt. Good job, bud. Dylan Robert Schmidt. Elizabeth Jean Sleeper. Matthew Spencer Walther. Claire Angeline Weber. Aurora May Zamora. Josie Aaron Zettel. And we have two graduates that weren't able to be at the ceremony, Xavier Seth Evans and Cheryl Josephine Swan. Friends, family, and board members and staff, tonight's gonna look a little bit different. Just kinda wanna explain the next procedure, what we're gonna do. Once the class exits, they're going to go to the library. We normally have a meet and greet in the commons. Unfortunately, we can't do that. What we are asking of you is exit either those doors, the red doors down there, or the doors you came in on as quickly as possible. If you could go back to your vehicles, as soon as everybody is out and you're in your vehicles, then we'd like you to get ready to if you saw my letter, honk and holler as loud as you possibly can. We are well then introduce the seniors as they walk out. As they walk out onto the sidewalk, please make as much noise as you possibly can for each graduate. They will then enter their cars. They will then, after all the seniors have been through and introduced on the sidewalk, they will then get in their cars and then go with a police escort down to Community Hall. So they will lead the parade, and then staff, or parents and family, please follow to Community Hall. So I hope that's exciting for them. I hope that's exciting for families too. I look forward to hearing a lot of noise. So graduates, please rise. That means stand up. There you go. All right. Please place your tassel on the left side of your mortarboard. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the 2020 high school graduating class.